welcome to W3L Wrestling Showdown. Thank you for joining us, for subscribing, and for having got your tickets for this Saturday. Because yes, we are just mere days away from the 2017 edition of Seven Deadly Sins. It happens this Saturday. Yeah, that's right, May 13th, this Saturday, in Stockton and Harrogate. For the first time in history, we're splitting the tournament over two live events. And for the first time in history, we're going to be in England to host the tournament as well. So come out, see Seven Deadly Sins, and see what happens on what will be an historic night. Who are your seven participants in pro wrestling's toughest tournament? They are your tag team champions, the contingency plan of Dickie Divers and Taylor Bryan, Lucien Maynard Smith, the very good Mr. Eugene Mackey, Kevin Williams, The Rock and Roll Express, Blondie Barrett, and the merchandise, Mike Musso. Seven men, all determined to win this year's tournament and get that guaranteed shot at the Heavyweight Championship. In addition to that, I can reveal that former Women's Champion Sarah is going to be in action, taking on Little Miss Roxy, and there'll be much more besides, I am sure. So get along to Stockton and Harrogate, go to our website right now for you, whatever tickets may be remaining, and come along and see history being made as professional wrestling's toughest tournament at Stockton and Harrogate. But speaking of the heavyweight title, everybody wants a shot at this championship. It's the most prestigious prize that we have, and one of the people that has recently been most vocal about getting a title shot is a former champion and a member of the contingency plan, James Scott. He wants a title shot in the worst way, but to get it, he's going to have to go through this week's roadblock in the form of the merchandise, Mike Musso. Now, you know full well all the situation that's been going on with Musso and Mackey, so to say that Musso's not in a good mood is a bit of an understatement. Can James Scott knock him off his perch and march on to heavy title shot? Or is Musso going to defeat the contingency plan member en route to winning Seven Deadly Sins? Let's all find out as we go to ringside for this week's match.
Gentlemen, this is Joe Fordyce here with you on a wrestling showdown. In a one-on-one match here, we have got James Scott taking on the merchandise, Mike Musso.
Yeah.
Needless to say, these comments are not necessarily those of W3L management. James Scott has his own opinions. Again, ladies and gentlemen, these comments are entirely those of the two participants. Certainly some strong words, some fighting words. What promises to be a very dramatic match, I am sure. Two men who are no strangers to each other, Mike Musso and James Scott. Going at it in singles competition. They fought numerous times here in W3L. And this crowd fumbling on the side of Mike Musso. Is it invariably they are, however we go. Chicken at James Scott. I mean, you know the old adage about good start an argument in an empty room. That is James Scott, sour of attitude. It's not helped by his two contingency plan cohorts who weirdly aren't at ringside. And normally where one is, the other two are not too far behind. So we'll see how that plays out later on. But certainly Scott's a very capable talent, it's just his attitude's terrible. We saw Mike Musso last week coming in to save Leah Owens from the very good Mr. Yuen Chi Mackey. A couple weeks ago he wrestled Tim Wiley. And we all know that he's had his problem with Mackey. We don't need to go into it this week in Showdown. I'm sure you know all about it. Watch previous episodes of this programme if you haven't. And stay tuned to W3LWrestling.com as well. There's the bell again, which is already rung, but regardless, I don't know if that means the match is technically over now, is it? But I guess we're having an official restart, so we're finally getting some action as both men walk up, and Musso's backing Scott in the corner. Musso's got a lot of pent-up frustration. The situation with Mackey is raging throughout W3L. It's taken in other parts of the company. Of course, Mackey going after women's champion Leo Owens last week. And Musso feels some pressure about that. The whole Mackey situation has annoyed him. So this is, he's got a lot of pent-up frustration basically, and I think Scott's going to be a good target for him to take it out on. But Scott has targeted Musso as he pulls the hair, trying to back him at the corner. Scott's going after Musso because they're two of the men that are furthest up the ladder of contention, and Scott's been talking about a heavy title shot. And Musso would love one as well. I would think a victory here would certainly put the winner in line for an opportunity to heavyweight title. Of course, our champion Nathan Reynolds hasn't been around for a few weeks due to injury. James Scott just biding his time, going to the floor, dictating the pace in some ways, and Miss just content to let him. I think everybody in the building getting on James Scott's back. No wonder, because he insulted him earlier on. and Scott wants to test his strength. He's a powerfully built man, has to be said. Because Musso does have a leverage advantage, just being that little bit taller. This crowd firmly thinks it's Musso. And we shall find out. Scott just taking his time, his one hand locked. And immediately kicks Musso in the midsection. I can never trust James Scott, really. I mean, you know he's going to break the rules wherever he can. It's just, that's how he's been here at W3L since he returned. And these two men, as I said, have fought numerous times. Most notably, what about on November of 2015 here in Showdown, when it was James Scott miraculously reappeared in W3L after years as part of the contingency plan. That threw everybody off their game. And of course, he and Dickie Divers defeated Musso and Nathan Reynolds in a tables match, and they put Musso through a table. And they met on the anniversary edition of Showdown, that four-way elimination match for the Heavyweight Championship. We all know what happened there with Joey Legend becoming the champion. And he fought countless other times as well. I'm not detailing them all. There's been a few here on Showdown. Scott just throwing the pace down. Needs to control how this match goes. Musso hoists him up with ease. And deposits James Scott right in the middle of the ring. An adventure to say that when Musso looks at Scott, he sees black and green. And by that I mean that Musso is projecting the very good Mr. Yuji Maki onto every opponent. So he can help take out some of his frustration on them, I think. Scott says it's easy, but I don't think he's realised that Musso's not on the floor. James Scott hits the turnbuckle. And again. And so far, despite all his big talk, this match has been firmly going Mike Musso's way. Lands that closing off the top rope. He's going to end this one early, I think. James Scott down for the count. But kicking out though. See Musso got a lot of adrenaline in him, a lot of fire, a lot of energy. This is a good catharsis for him. If he can't beat up Yuji Maki, he'll beat up the next best thing. And Musso, maybe a little hot-headed, charged in. I think he caught his leg on the apron as he went down. Bear in mind, the apron doesn't have any padding on it, so it's just wooden metal. So because landing on that is never good. And Scott targeting that leg. Trying to get a chair from the crowd, but they're holding on to it. They don't want him to use it on Musso. Shows how popular this man is. I said before, he's the backbone of W3L. He's the one everybody knows. There's a fan getting involved with inflatable hammer. They do not count as foreign objects in the W3L handbook. Well, hang on, Musso's up for that. And Scott being hammered. We've seen Musso in inflatable hammer matches before. It's something of his speciality, his raison d'etre, you might say. So if you come to W3L and buy a hammer, and Scott being mobbed, and this has become a handicap match. It's like a 50-on-1 handicap match. And normally it's a contingency plan to let the numbers advantage. And Scott tried to escape. Oh, and he catches Musso just no more. But there's fans everywhere. And then he's set up a chair. What Scott got in mind. And the atomic drops Mike Musso onto the chair. It's a nasty landing. Musso's face tells a story in that one. The same face that James Scott's trying to rip apart. The referee just letting this one go. He knows the high stakes involved. He knows the tension between these two men. Because Musso and the contingency plan have been battling each other for a long, long, long time. Over by the souvenir stand. And a Mongolian chop. Oh, he's going to throw one of the souvenirs. Oh, Musso blocks it. Bear in mind, any damages won't be paid for. I'm not entirely sure Scott's pay packet for this evening is going to cover all those damages. Musso to a pill diver. Not on this floor. You see there's no mats or anything. And Musso kicking his legs, trying to lower his centre of gravity and fight out of it. And Scott slips out the back of that body slam, and Musso goes heavily at the post. And those ring posts are rock solid, ladies and gentlemen. And there's him for the cover. But a kick out. Musso went face first into that post, and that will slow any momentum down. No matter how good the rest of you are, how much experience you have, being run face first into the metal post is going to stop you in your tracks. And this is where James Scott is going to be able to take over if he can. We know Musso's resilient, we know he can fight back from almost insurmountable odds, but there's only so much you can do. Scott working the hand and the wrist, it seems. Mike Musso bending it around those ropes. Because you can't pick anything up, you can't make a fist, you can't grip. It makes your match that much harder, particularly for somebody like Musso, who likes a lot of slams, likes a lot of strikes. So his arms are very important to him. And Scott just now being slow as he goes in for the cover. What a horrible cover as well. Just kneeling on his chest, talk about disrespectful. And it should be noted that James Scott's initial tenure in W3L, way back in 2009-2010, saw him actually... Well, hang on, Musso has a sunset flip! And so close there. Musso out of nowhere, but you see Scott charges straight back up and knocks him down. It was at our Seven Deadly Sins event in the April of 2010. James Scott won the heavyweight championship, so far his only one to date, and he did it by defeating Mike Musso. So he knows what it takes to beat Musso in a high stakes situation. However, that was 7 years ago. Both men have progressed since then. They've gained 7 more years of experience, if nothing else. Their careers, their lives have shaped them differently, they've gone different paths. So I'm not sure that what Scott did back then is going to work now. As he drops down his spine in Musso. And locking that camel clutch. He's just pulling back on the head and neck. Also the lower back is getting wrenched in the wrong direction as well. Musso's alleviated it somewhat by being on his knees. He was flat on his face. Out of his back being arched in the wrong direction, so it's more perhaps head and neck they're getting this. Musso trying to get up. He's a powerfully built man. He's got £30 over James Scott. He's going to sound a lot. But when that £30 comes flying at you, you'll know all about it. And Scott jumps in his bag like a sleeper. And again, he's tenacious. He's not going to let Musso get away. Musso ramming at the turnbuckles. That's good ring awareness. And you see Mike just taking those moments before following up. That's what allows Scott to get that kick in. Oh, what a close light, and Musso didn't go down. The fairest thing, the ropes kind of helped him up. Oh, and right in the foot. Musso got that boot up. And both men with the same idea. Each in a clothesline, and both men go down. And I'm not sure who's taking the worst of this. I think Musso probably after being run at the ring post, but Scott is taking some punishment as well. Musso's gotten a couple of good shots. Every time he's had the opportunity, he's fired back and has struck Scott. And again, Musso's been going since 2001. So he knows what to do to beat people. He's beaten James Scott before. So he knows where to strike and how to do it. And you see Musso firing back. He's been trading forearms. Musso's on rubber legs, and he's barely standing. Certainly Scott seems more stable than he does. Musso picks him up and just dumps him down from a great height and lands a big splash of the cover here. This could end it. James Scott just gets a shoulder of the canvas and no more. What's Musso got set for here? Scott hits the corner hard. And Musso with the face buster. And another knee lift. Again, nobody throws a knee lift quite like Mike Musso. Just perched in the middle, Tomical biding his time. Keep preparing for a clothesline here. He has been hitting a flying body press of late. And you see Scott slow to get up. Musso does hit the body press. Wraps him up. I think we're going to have this match ended here. James Scott able to kick out, being the fresher man has assisted him there. Musso with a cradle suplex, bridges out. And Scott just got the arm on the canvas. That was literally millimetres away. Musso dropping an elbow on him. Links to his elbows off the top rope. He just jumps and drops one now. And Scott writhing about in agony. He's had three elbows drop right in his chest. May have cracked a sternum. I think Musso maybe going for a fourth elbow, and perhaps this time off the top turnbuckle. And you know that Nathan Reynolds, whoever he is, should be paying close attention to this one. And wait a minute, there's a contingency plan. Dickie Divers and Taylor Bryden, the referee, hasn't called his disqualification as yet. Scott's got hold of him and slams Musso off the top turnbuckle. Hoots a leg. But Musso not go down without a fight. James Scott arguing it was a three. And can't quite believe that's not happened. And Divers and Bryden, we knew they'd show up somewhere. The contingency plan are like wolves, they always run in a pack. I mean, they always come to ringside, but you know they're always about somewhere. And Divers has grabbed a chair. Now the referee really needs to step in here. I know he's not got a lot of refereeing experience, but even so, Scott threatening him. He's going to nail Musso with his chair. And, oh, Musso hits a double stunner on Bryden and Divers. And now kicks Scott in the face. I think James Scott was taken a bit by surprise there. So he didn't follow up with the attack. And Bryden and Divers have just been stunned. And Bryden gets launched to the floor. And see if he's checking on Divers. Scott swings a chair. Musso hooks him up. Blunt force trauma on the way. Wait a minute, there's Mackey. Oh, with the Eflins right in the face. He blasts Eflins right in the face of Mike Musso. And he's stumbling all over the joint. Scott's picked him up. Oh, and drags him down with a fireman's driver. Right in the back of the skull. Hooks a leg. And he's just scored a pin. So thanks to the very good Mr. Yuji Maki, James Scott steals a victory over Mike Musso here this week on Wrestling Showdown.
Well, it looks very much like James Scott may have just put himself in line for a championship match. But there's a question mark because, as you know, the heavyweight champion Nathan Reynolds is on the injured list. He, of course, suffered an injury at a Remedy event, has tried to continue on and work through it, but just exacerbated. And he hasn't been active very recently here in W3L. Is he able, physically able, to defend the championship? I am told we're going to try and get a resolution about this next week here on Showdown, so make sure you've subscribed and we'll try and find out the situation involving Nathan Reynolds and the heavyweight title. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as I already said, coming up this Saturday, it's Seven Deadly Sins. It's in Stockton and in Harrogate, two shows on the same day, one in the afternoon, one in the evening, and Seven Deadly Sins is split across both of those events. Come out, see us, get your tickets from our website. And while you're there, buy them for the day after Sunday, May 14th. We go to Kinghorn. We will have all the Seven Deadly Sins fallout, an event not to be missed. Then next week, on May 18th, which is a Thursday, we go up to Oban for our first time there. The day after that, which is the Friday, we hit Bedlington, and then on Saturday is Hexham and Catterick. Again, one show in the afternoon and one show in the evening. Then Thursday, May 25th, we go to Jedburgh before our live events come to a temporary halt on May 26th as we hit Musselburgh on the Friday night. This is going to be some tremendous live events coming up. So I'm sure you can make it to at least one of them. And you owe it to yourself, because nothing beats seeing W3L in the flesh. This is good, this is great. But seeing us live is really where it's at. So make sure you get along and come out to see us. And you can do that by going to our website. We're at W3LWrestling.com. Buy your tickets there. Use the word Showdown as a coupon code and you get 20% off them, which seems like a bargain to me. Make sure you've liked us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter for all the up-to-the-minute news from W3L. Use the hashtag W3L Wrestling Showdown. And if you talk about this show, and you really should, subscribe to this channel and then get ready. Because Stockton, Harrogate, we're coming for you. And we're bringing professional wrestling's toughest tournament. We'll see you on Saturday. And then we'll see you on Sunday live in Kinghorn. And also back here on the W3L Network for another edition of Wrestling Showdown.